For years, Smart Layout has afforded us a ton of additional flexibility with our symbols, allowing us to make instances grow and shrink when their content changes. Smart Layout maintains padding and spacing between layers, resizing containers, and moving adjacent layers automatically, without tediously nudging things around manually. Symbols were a start, but Smart Layout was always destined for bigger things. Now, we're taking Smart Layout beyond symbols, allowing you to apply its magic to both groups and artboards. In this video, I'm going to show you all of the improvements we've made to Smart Layout. And to do that, we're going back to basics. So if you're a beginner, you'll feel right at home. And if you think you know a thing or two about Smart Layout, well, maybe you should watch along anyway. You might pick up a new trick or two. Step one is to identify an opportunity to use Smart Layout in the first place. If you come across a horizontal row or a vertical column of design elements, you've found a perfect candidate. This card is a great example. We have a photo, a block of grouped up information, and a call to action button, laid out vertically with 16 pixel gaps between them. Before Smart Layout, if we wanted to do something as simple as make this photo a little bit taller, we would have to move the other layers out of the way. And even if we take a shortcut by selecting all three chunks and retype the correct amount of vertical spacing in the inspector, we would still have to manually fix the height of the background rectangle. Definitely a pain. But never again if we apply Smart Layout to the parent group for these layers. With the group selected, you'll find new layout controls on the inspector, where we can choose either a horizontal or vertical layout. In this case, the children of this group are definitely in a vertical layout. Then we choose if we want the group to expand and contract from the top edge, middle, or bottom edge. In this case, I want the card to expand from top to bottom. That's it. Now, when we make a change to the height of this image, we trigger Smart Layout. It automatically maintains the perfect spacing by moving the other layers out of the way, even growing and shrinking the rectangle in the background to maintain the padding. That's more like it. You can also apply Smart Layout to a selected group with a new two-step keyboard shortcut. First, press Command L, then tap the arrow key that points in the direction of your desired layout. You'll see a nice reminder at the bottom of the canvas of which keys do what, which include H for a horizontally centered layout, V for a vertically centered layout, and L to set the layout back to none. If you use these shortcuts on a multi-selection containing at least one layer, they'll get grouped up automatically all in one step. And unlike more rigid stack-based layouts in many other tools, you can still freely reposition layers and even space them unevenly. Smart Layout will figure out the rest. Dragging to resize a layer was just one example of an action that triggers Smart Layout. But let's go over each of the other actions that'll trigger Smart Layout as well. A subtly different example is adjusting the size of a layer on the inspector, where using a math operator will now show how the whole layout will be affected with foresight guides on the canvas. And as you might expect, the scale tool also has a similar effect to resizing. If you need a moment to adjust something without triggering Smart Layout, you can pause it at any time from Layer, Layout, Pause Smart Layout, or by pressing Option Command L on the keyboard. You'll see a little reminder at the bottom of the canvas. When you click away to deselect or dismiss the reminder, you'll reactivate Smart Layout. Another action that triggers Smart Layout is editing the content of a text box. As the bounding box of an auto height or auto width text box grows and shrinks to fit the content, other layers will move or resize accordingly. Similarly, editing the style of text, like size, line spacing, character spacing, etc., will trigger Smart Layout as well. You can also drag elements directly onto a Smart Layout group to insert them. You'll see an orange guide that shows which side of the gap the layer will be placed on. With the guide in the middle, the gap won't be split in half. It'll be preserved on both sides of the inserted layer. For those cases where you do need to position something like a tooltip or a popover directly on top, you can hold the Control key to ignore insert mode altogether. When deleting or cutting a layer, Smart Layout even figures out the correct amount of spacing to leave behind. And with Swap at Original Size enabled, Smart Layout will also kick in when swapping between symbols of different sizes. And don't forget that you can apply Smart Layout to artboards too. In this case, I can apply a vertical layout to this phone screen, so it'll automatically get shorter or longer to make room for adjustments I make to its contents. Like duplicating a layer with Command D. The duplicated layer gets placed after the selected layer in the direction of the selected layout. If the layer is part of an evenly spaced group, the same spacing will apply to the duplicate too. or you can also copy and paste something from elsewhere. Option dragging to duplicate a layer works too, but with the added control of inserting the duplicate where you want it. When you select a layer in a group where every layer is evenly spaced, you'll see the Smart Distribute handles appear. Dragging them to adjust spacing will trigger Smart Layout as well, as long as this group is nested within a Smart Layout group, of course. Though the bulk of what's new is with groups and artboards, we've made an improvement to overrides made on image layers within a symbol. Now, when you override an image with another of a different size or aspect ratio, you'll be able to adjust the resizing behavior of the image on the inspector. You can stretch the new image to occupy the same height and width, scale the new image to its original size, have it fit entirely within the footprint of the source image, or have it fill the footprint of the source image. With Smart Layout now in symbols, groups, and artboards, you can spend more time focusing on what matters, and let Sketch handle the rest.